Welcome back to the chamber. Photo means five photos.
We all make mistakes.
I agree with that. This with you, you've got 5 minutes.
Thank you.
All right, so.
Think I'll think about two.
Oh, that's all right.
Your worship, councillors, Mr. CEO, thank you for seeing us this morning. Here we go. The info I'm working on is supplied by Sarah Flavel. And the cost of the leaf place, by the way, I'm only going to look at finance. I'm generally known as a money man in that if I join, say, the club or the achievement centre, I usually get the job of treasurer for some unknown reason, mainly because I'm me. But the information I have is that the building to replace the eye centre and the toilets and a bit more will cost 1.7 million. The other works, probably rather curbing and channeling, 1.5 million professional fees, $400,000. To replace the inflow office and toilets, 1.7 million I consider to be ridiculous. Even more ridiculous is the professional fees of $400,000. Presumably, this estimate was obtained from either Messrs. Richard Turpin or Edward Kelly. It's something right. As the project includes no heavy engineering, e.g. bridge building, a fee of 12.5% on the total cost is excessive, immoral, obscene and extravagant. An individual paying such a fee on such a straightforward project would be an idiot. And a committee member authorizing such a fee would be irresponsible. In conclusion, I would say I have heard of no one other than councillors in the local population who are in favour of the changed traffic system and buildings. Thank you very much, Your Worship.
Thank you. Thank you for taking the time to present.
Have a good one.
And you too. Mr. Hogarth.
Thank you, Mayor Jane and Councillor, for your time and attention. It's with real disappointment for our community, I acknowledge Council's decision that they're going to go ahead with Leaf Place upgrade as it's been proposed. Approximately three weeks ago, Mayor Jane clearly stated to a small group that this was not the case. Nothing but the removal of the trees was set in concrete. Your recent email to me, Jenny, certainly denies this. And those present, for those present, Craig, I'd like to ask you, now that this is a fait accompli and in concrete, what is this project going to cost us?
It's the fixed budget, Mr. Hogarth, that's been referred to by Expert Booth, so that's the budget we're working with.
That, I understand that it's only an estimate. Who is the contractor going to do this job?
We haven't determined that yet, but the budget has been set by council and working on that.
So how can you set a budget when you don't have a fixed cost?
The point of order, Madam Chair, is this an interrogation or a presentation?
Simple question. I apologise. I'll move on. I delivered to council out of the courtesy and respect for the opinions of the 500 plus that signed this petition. Even though Mayor Shattuck put it in print, it won't change council's decision, contrary to her previous statement to others. This petition, signed by 500 plus, opposes the following decision of council: changing the traffic flow and removing 32 car parks. shifting any talking poles, building a new eye site. Is there some concern about the statement you made to us there?
No, continue, you've got 5 minutes, Mr. Hoggard.
I have a letter endorsing this, but you wish to read it. The petition does support the replacement or upgrade of the toilets, and the petition certainly endorses the improvement that the removal of the trees has made. It's given our town a good opportunity to create an incredible front door. And providing council move on, and on the recommendation of our chemist in town, follows that format and delays spending the money they're proposing to spend, I think this community will be benefit significantly. Underlying this, and the view of the previous speakers on this leaf plate upgrade, are the following points. This community has had announced that they can expect a 20% increase in rates over the next 2 years. That's going to represent somewhere between $400 and $500 per year each rate payer, each residential rate payer, and some $5,000 average for each farmer. To impose an additional $2 million spend on upgrading leaf plate is totally irresponsible and not necessary. We live in an ageing community that needs access to its retail activities, and we are a community that is failing in generating substantial revenue income for the individual families that we've been used to. Please, Council, take a deep breath. Look in the mirror tomorrow morning and ask yourself, are you sincerely serving this community that has elected you to produce good governance to our community? Thank you.